the Federal Republic of Somalia. In a capacity of an independent expert on the situation of human rights in Somalia, and therefore, this is my last press conference with you. I was appointed to this mandate by the United Nations Human Rights Council on 8th May 2014. My first mission to Somalia was in December 2014. My mission this time has started on the 15th of July. I started with meetings in Nairobi, I went to Hargeisa, and I'm now completing the last part of my days, which I spent in Mogadishu. While in Mogadishu, I met the speaker and the members of the Human Rights Committee of the Federal Parliament. I met federal ministers responsible for water and energy, constitutional affairs, justice, health, and the Minister for Women and Human Rights Development. I also met other people, including the representatives of ANSOM, AMISOM, trade unionists, and representatives of civil society. In Somaliland, I met the Speaker of the Somaliland Parliament, the Attorney General, the Minister for Justice, and the Somaliland Human Rights Commission, as well as the representatives of civil society. I wish to extend my thanks to all of those who availed their time to me to discuss pressing issues, the human rights issues in Somalia, but also opportunities for this country to consolidate and sustain the peace building and reconciliation process, and more in which area quite a lot have been achieved over the past few years. I'll be detailing some of those achievements during the later part. During the mission, among the things which I discussed with the authorities include challenges that Somalia continues to experience, particularly regarding the conflicts, the terrorist attacks and bombs, as you have had these 2 days, several happened while I was here. There continues to be experiences of inequality and discrimination, and challenges to the realization of best rights such as access to water, access to land, access to health facilities, and education, particularly for girls, and internally displaced persons, and minority clans, and other marginalized communities. I will therefore be reading some of the issues that I raised, particularly with regard to some of the sectors. In the justice and security sector, I expressed my concern on the delay in the operationalization of the National Human Rights Commission, of which we know the selection process was completed sometime in 2017. The delay in operationalization affects the appointment of the union, Denmark and Norway for their support and contribution of resources to the joint human rights program. As I conclude my mission, I would like to extend my sincere appreciation to the people of the Federal Republic of Somalia, to His Excellency President Farmaajo, and all the federal member states for the opportunity they afforded me to be able to play a little which has contributed to the improvement of the human rights situation in this country. And I also do so on behalf of my predecessors, because as I said, there have been other human rights independent experts in the past 25 years. And as I conclude also, I wish to urge the international community to continue its support to Somalia, because so far the support has enhanced the stability of this country progressively, and it has shown that stability is a reality if we continue working together. But I particularly want to emphasize that they need to continue supporting the federal ahead of the 2021 elections, 2020 and 2021 elections, because we would like to see the elections are held in an environment which will, first of all, guarantee credible elections, but also they will enhance the process of establishing a democratic Somalia. I also wish to, again, remind the international community to support the government as it faces challenges in dealing with negative effects of climate change.